Hey you guys, this is a scrim from last Saturday. I wasn't gonna never mind that. So I was gonna put this video up before the game started, but I noticed that there's a lot of this really weird sort of stutteriness. I don't know if anybody else even notices it, but it really annoys me. So I spent a few hours trying to fix it, but I couldn't quite. I think it's just the way that the demo is recorded. I don't think I can fix it now. I think it's too late. But yes, this is Koth Warmtic, and it's the map that we played last week, but it's important. This is just a scrim we played beforehand, and because I was gonna put my other one up, but it's I played with like 140 ping. I'm actually gonna restart this because I'm just talking about other stuff now. Let's go to zero and go to. So I used like 150 ping for most of it, or close to it, for the first half. So I was really gun heavy for the whole thing. So I'm just going to resume this, and I will get more videos of Badwater and Vanguard and stuff like that up soon. I promise. Okay, so game starts. Don't use the kunai. Thank you, Graggy, for the lurker's leathers, by the way. I quite like them. They go well with my Halloween set. Always the No Mercy. No Mercy is just the best spy item. So straight away, come out. I like to roll out to the right here because it's so that you're rolling out with the flank a bit more. Like, I find that Chaco was kind of going here, Chaco being the sniper. And, we had Lucas, yeah, actually playing Sully, I think, tonight. Calling out where the scout is. This engineer, if I remember rightly, was running this level 3 strat on this map, which was actually pretty effective, the level 3's work on this map. But you have to base it on the teleporter, I think. Okay, so there I was caught by the heavy. I shouldn't have gone for drop down, but head drop down was half to sort of get away from the heavy. I should have probably just backed out into banana. I was kind of giving my life away there. The heavy was definitely going to shout, calling me out. So scouts and banana, because that's what that's called. Q goes down here. Oh yeah, this was I think a disconnect between our demo and basically I don't really know how they managed to get quite so much damage on, because we quick fixed in there and Ada thought that he wasn't being healed, even though Q was saying she was healing him constantly. So I think that they somehow managed to just do a boatload of damage. Don't want to get caught here. Look, at that point, if you end up in that fight with that scout where I immediately go in and I'm only on 60 health, I'm not even going to try and fight it. If he was low, or if I managed to get some early damage on him, it would be a different story. But no, that's not a situation I want to be in. I'm just going to get out of there, because otherwise I'm just throwing my life away without anything. I don't even know how I spotted the teleporter there. I managed to get rid of it anyway. So here we're going to move out this way. This is a bit of a dangerous move. See, I noticed that the pyre was always playing kind of quite close to drop down, so drop down is kind of a dangerous place. It can be worth it sometimes, I suppose, but depends. So move up here, miss the stab, get the scout, and just decide it's time to leave. Sully catches me though. The soldier, I might have gotten out there if the soldier hadn't been coming underneath. I find that situations like that, if you aren't that interested in taking on the pyro, which I wasn't because he was buffed, I was just going to run straight lines out of there. I don't even look at the pyro. So here, I'm going to be on fire for the next probably ages, because demos are still not fixed. With the same complaints I have like in every video. And so I'm going to move out here to the right again, do a bit of work with my gun before I manage to get across the point. Just see what I can get. A lot of spam coming out here. Again, I probably get called out there for being on the roof, so I realize there's no point in me being cloaked. And here I'm trying to spam out the gun actually, because I see that it's actually quite low over there in banana. But this is what I mean, that the thing was going for, NG was playing with the level 3s a lot of the time. There, I just want to spam the scout out. I was never really trying to kill him, but at that range I can get out myself and I can do a bit of damage to him to make it easier for Yanni to come in here and finish him, which he does. But unfortunately the spy comes in, I think, takes Yanni. Yeah. And he gets me too. If I remember, I think this is the other spy who was good with the revolver. Should have worn my unusual. Ugh. Then we could have been unusual buddies. Okay, so Q goes down here to a body shot. I'm actually going to pause and get rid of these flames, because why not? No, I was about to say, oh my god, have they updated the way the demos work? Nope. I wonder if I should maybe update my P-Rec, actually. That'll probably help. So, gonna do a bit of damage to the scout and then let Yanni finish him. got to move out this side. This side, I don't know what it is about. I found that I was, because of the way out of here is such a narrow choke point with like the soldier. It was found I was running into the soldier way more often than I had to. But so aggressive decloak, sap in here. Gotta try. Yes. Do I? No, I don't manage to get the gun down. Oh yeah, but then. Cobra. Oh no, it was Cobra who was playing Silly Frizz. Yeah, Cobra came in and finished off the gun. So, you know, just when I was sapping that there, I didn't realize that I had kind of no teammates around. So it was important that when I started to sap it, I started to tell people I was going to sap it. Because then it makes it really, really easy for our team to just spam it out. Especially because I'd drawn, as well as that, I took a look at how many players I'd drawn in on top of me when I was trying to do it. I'd like the Pyro and the Engineer there were quite close to me, and there's the Combo were there too. So if they're spamming the gun, you know, it's a lot of really easy targets all in one place there for a Demo Man or a Soldier. So here again, like, I mean, I'm on the point, I'm the spy, they're really not going to focus me. If they're focusing me with all those other players there, then that's their mistake. Call it the Soldier's going to drop down. So I knew I was kind of fairly okay to just go and get a bit of spam. So now, unfortunately, I don't know if anybody spots me here. Yeah, this is, get the Pyro. And then Chaco just nails the medic, so all is good. I was happy enough with my Pyro pick, to be honest. It was, considering how it didn't really make a difference. At that point as well, that if I was that close to the Pyro and I hadn't stabbed him, he would have just turned around and killed me anyway, so I was better off with that kill. And yeah, and he comes here. Oh, does he get it? Does he get it? No. Oh. So close. So here we're in pretty bad time deficit and they're about to cap again. With the Sully on that part of the point, I know that they probably have a lot of presence. But actually, no. Kitsy was moving up there. Sully got behind somehow. Call it the Demo Man's Health. Very important to do. In case any of you are wondering, I use Sir Grey's Hood, which is getting more and more outdated all the time. I was on a server with him recently, actually, and I was trying to tell him I liked his hood. I should have asked him when he was going to update it. So strafe across, get the medic. And get the Pyro actually as well. Scout's gonna catch me though. Oh, yeah, I'm milked as well. Probably on fire too. Yeah, Scout's following me. Yeah, I gotta. See, I stayed invisible there because I knew I could pick up the ammo in that room, and also because now you actually don't stay milked for as long if you're invisible. So there's still a point to stay invisible even though he can see you. And I did get the milk off me, but I actually unfortunately bumped him as well, so he knew where I was. Sully's jumping on it. Important to tell him this because after he rolls out, he's probably going to be quite low. And down he goes anyway. I still managed to kill him, but still. Oh, and Code actually timed out at that point, so we were 8v9 for quite a bit of this. Gotta do a bit of damage. Get the medic actually here. Yeah, somebody called out that I think it was Chaco called out he'd taken 130. So, I mean, at that range, I can easily do something like that. No, unfortunately. Yeah. No, looking at that point there, I was going to say maybe if I hadn't muddled my jump there, I could have maybe just gotten out of the point and just gotten something or other, but just by bought a bit of time. There were so many players, I really wouldn't have lasted. I would have had to time a pick on the Demo Man or something to really do it, and then there was no time for that. Ooh, look at that flashy blue gun. Ooh, so nice. Professional kill streak. So it's called the Scout's going grab down. He changes his mind when he sees there's so many players there. Their combo were holding a banana a lot actually in this game. So, Sully's there spamming from on top, but he gets taken out. So I'm kind of free to move through here. Yeah, Pyro. A lot of the time, I was actually quite a big risk of getting healed by that Pyro just because of how close he was standing. So just go across as the soldier. You see, the Pyro didn't even look at me twice there. I managed to get the Pyro to back out here, which is it's a nice feeling to get against the Pyro. That you've bullied them away, but I could have stayed and helped Yanni out there, but generally with, you know, 1v1 scout battles, if you're cloaked going into it, you usually don't have time to sort of like now this that at that point I kind of knew I was screwed. I maybe should have cloaked and tried to get away, but I said it, I wasn't ever going to kill him with the thing. That was just a bad decloak, really. I kind of wanted to get the sniper, but yeah, if you're 1v1, if you see a scout 1v1, if you're not cloaked, if you're arriving at that stage of it, it can be really, really hard for you to even get in there in time to make a difference. Though I do really like to help scout V1v1s out if I can. Code looking suspicious. So the reason I got the medic there as well is because I got the soldier disguise and the Pyro didn't even look at me there. Like he flamed me by mistake and he wasn't even looking at me. So the soldier disguise, again, really, really good. Really, really situational, but it can work out so well. So, now here, yeah, this is where I discovered what the engineer was doing. I realized then that he was using the that's how he was getting the big sentries to the middle. He wasn't building them at middle, he was teleporting with them. So Fortunately, I just landed right in the middle of a big spawn wave, which I should have been checking really. I should have had a look and seen what who was up. So the jumping doesn't seem too bad, or I've just stopped noticing it. Basically, I think it's to do with the way it's recorded. I don't think it's anything to do with the I don't think there's anything I can do now about it. Hopefully the YouTube render will just sort of clean it up a little bit. So here, I call it how low the heavy is. Doesn't even matter. Chaco's going to dome him for 150. obvious spy. I think he hits me with a headshot here. No, I back out because I'm afraid of him. I get milked. Again, I'm just trying to help Kitsy out here. Stop him from dying. Maybe soak up a bit of the damage if I can. Or at least just attract a bit of it. So I'm going to let Kitsy fall back and go back to Q. I'm not going to take the health myself. I'm at 80, and to be honest, there was other players around me that really needed it a bit more. The ammo, on the other hand, that I need. So, Demo's probably going to call me out here. So move to the right and then rotate around. Try underneath. You see, underneath is a really bad sort of, it's not a great place to push through if you're just using the revolver, because you haven't really got all that much time to cloak, and often you'll meet a scout or a soldier there, or occasionally their combo. So here, I want to just, you see that things, guns getting spammed, so should have gone invisible there, probably a bad move, but I think the gun goes down here anyway. Yeah, there, yeah, he gets it. Unfortunately, oh yeah, he gets Cobra, the thing. So I spawn with Q, so just take a bit of the heals. I think, yeah, I'm the only spawn. So I'm here to check that gun. She's gone the other way. I should have gone with her, to be honest. So now I'm going to just do some more damage to the point. We actually have quite a bit of time on here. It's like an opposite situation to last round. So call it that soldier's gone top left as well. And yeah, managed to get a bit of damage on him. Just a bit of chip. I don't know if it made a difference, but still, it's a, you know, those little bits can be important. Ah, 21 HP, and the scout was all the way out there. So calling that where the sniper was, eventually the sniper, I think, I don't know if it was this game, but this, I think at one stage the sniper started to actually focus me when I started to spam from back there. I suppose there was an easy pick for him, in fairness, so makes sense. And move through here, spot the combo rolling out left, or parts of it. I should look behind me. Yeah, I do. Okay, I was like, if I didn't look behind me there, then that's me being a bad player. Run out here, can't really see the medic. Try not to look directly at the medic. Yeah, but unfortunately I look directly at the heavy and it's as obvious. What I was trying to do there was kind of move out and not look straight at medic if I saw him, because it's usually a big giveaway when you look straight at people. So try and just use the edges of the screen to spot the beam or something, and then strafe in that direction. I've gotten better at not running straight towards medics as well. I don't know why I had such a period there. I think there was a period where I wasn't getting used to, I played for like 3 seasons with quite low ping, and then I went into a season of bad ping, of high ping most of the time, and it's I don't know, I found my stabs and my positioning and stuff like that was a lot worse. So we win this round, and off to the next demo. Oh, that's gonna roll out left this time, I think. Yeah, again, this is the thing about these maps, they're sort of, you don't really know what the rollouts are or anything like that. Though I suppose it's probably established what the amount of 4v4 I've seen played on this map. Yes, I watch every kind of TF2. We even did like a 5v5 cot with bans on this map. Not like arena respawn, but we had respawns and stuff like that. But just 5v5 with bans on classes, and then a really Highlander whitelist. So it was actually really fun. I think that wouldn't be a bad game mode either. Well, I just think 6s with the more open whitelist and only one of each class might be a bit better. 6s is a, don't get me wrong, I mean 6s is a great format, but it's really, really restrictive at the minute. I think it's not particularly TF2-y the way it's set up. Oh my god, Yanni got caught so bad in that trap. Also, what does anyone think of Overwatch? It seems to be the thing everybody in TF2 is talking about, like it's going to destroy the game, but I don't really see it ruining TF2 somehow. I think people are trying to compare apples and oranges a lot. So here I'm going to go for this really aggressive decloak, and it works out. Should definitely have been called out there, and I know Sully's running the direct hit, so I thought I might get away with getting out of there. But, and it's always a good thing to say that I'm dominating the medic. I like that feeling, because I find there's generally games where it's going to go one or two ways. I'm going to get a load of picks on the flank, or I'm going to get a lot of medic picks. And it really depends, not so much on how I focus, but generally for the first part of a game, you'll always try and sort of test a medic or test a combo. See how the pyro is sort of checking and stuff. And if you find you can get away with a bit more than usual, which I could with this pyro, that's when I'll really try and go for the medic as much as possible. But then there's other games where the pyro's just been super defensive, and then it's just time to go for the flank and only really take the medic picks when you... whatchamacallit, we only see the relic picks when they come along. Oh, here, pumping the spy, awkward, you know, touch, clashing of swords. I have no idea how that killed me, but I suppose the engineer probably shot me from behind actually as well, because I was looking at that there. I was like, I should definitely have gotten the sap onto that before it was able to kill me, but I reckon that the NG shot me with the shotgun from behind looking at it back. So here I think I'm changing. No, oh, I got a phone call here. That was it, yeah. My phone was ringing while I was like alive that life, and then I just answered it, and it's like, I can't remember what it was. Yeah, no idea. So gonna move down underneath. I know from the way Andy's shooting and stuff like that that there's definitely somebody here. So let's go sneaky through. Okay, so I see the medics all the way around back in combo, back in banana. So have a quick look around me while I decloak. There's often people come from here. I want to grab this medal, but it's really obvious when you do. So the one thing about sapping this teleporter is that I'm more than likely going to be called out now. So I see the engineers coming back, so I'm going to try and move out now while he's gone the other way. And I force them, which is nice, but it's obviously not as nice as a pick. But yeah, a good force at the same time. And the thing is there that that's really bad, yeah. Shit. I don't know. I'm pretty sure I called out. I don't know, maybe I didn't call out that I forced them or something. Maybe my team wasn't expecting them to come in so aggressively. Here. This is myself. Yeah, no. Yeah, I feel like I had a lot of that with that scout. But Craggy's using the detonator. Oh, I love that thing. Detonator and the scorch shot. I just love those two so much. Alright, Sully's behind. Important to call that out. He was in the direct hit for a lot of this game, actually, which was working out quite well for him. Direct hit and gun bolts isn't something you usually see, because you're really putting your eggs in one basket. You're not having a good day for aim. It's really not going to work out for you. So here, yeah, again, it's just literally mutual spam both ways, so gonna just try and, you know, play with my team a little bit, see if I can get anything extra. Also, in the position we're in, myself and Chaco are a perfect place to spam this gun, so gonna keep doing that. I am almost running out of bullets, but I know that we're gonna run, myself and Chaco are gonna kill the gun before, like, between the two of us combined spam, we can do way more damage than the engineer can heal if he runs out of metal, especially, or runs out of Rescue Ranger bullets. And see the Zuber fading. Know that the medic still has to be up somewhere. Call it the medic's health. So Pyro just put him out, so gonna... I don't know why I went for this sap. It was probably silly of me, because I'm probably going to get called out here because of it. Now, playing as the sniper. Oh, missed that. Get 40 damage onto the medic, and not quite enough. I'd say maybe that the teleporter was called out or something. Maybe that's why he turned around. With that many players around, it's a lot of the time it can be a good bit of luck involved, whether or not somebody cops that you're a spy, because when there's so many players, you're just increasing the chances. It doesn't matter how good your acting is, you're increasing the chances of one of them realizing, or at least just calling out just for the sake of it, that maybe there's a spy. Because maybe there were like six players around me there, and I only use maybe four disguises most of the time, and they'll just, like, you know, call you out if they know that it's you or that you're not them. Oh, unfortunately, the scout. I really need to work on this invisible dodging. See, now I got away from him, but by the time I was away from him, I had like no cloak left. So, oh, I actually get hit Ubered here, but and then I get shot because I'm not the sniper. But I don't know, that must have been a fully charged shot or something like that, or I took more damage. I don't know, that medic did some amazing surfing while Ubered there. Q has been super aggressive. Fortunately, it doesn't work out. She did get a saw, but like, unfortunately, she also died. It's funny, those risky medic plays. It's like they're like all or nothing frag video fucking things. Also, I'm sure you'll have noticed that Q has a video on my channel now. which is her playing spy in a scrim for us on Vanguard. I may do my own Vanguard video. I'd say I probably will. Scout knows, want to kill sniper. Nope, can't do it, but fortunately the sniper is really low, so he gets killed. What's your name? And they're actually, they're heavy and their sniper have swapped at this stage. Also, I'm getting all these weird things with my HUD. Like, say for instance, a hat over my player character model's head and stuff like that. I don't know. This particular one seems to have broken. This particular update seems to have broken this HUD the most. I'll probably still use it for competitive, but I don't know. I might look towards something else, or I might just shoot Sir Gray an email and be like, yo, any chance you updating your HUD there? Bye. Yeah, he pulls out the fish actually, but I get him. Shocker. He was mad when for the fish, so he was. Love those fish kills. I think it was the fish anyway. Unless I'm confusing him with some other scout. No, there's the fish. Yep. I think he gets a fish kill on somebody else later. Spoilers, oh no. Okay, so, can't let the damn man. Ah, unfortunately, he gets an arrow. And I think a second one as well. So, spy's over there. Gonna shoot at him with my bullets. Take a little bit of damage and then move through drop down. I'm always sort of coming through drop down. I think the pyro knows, but I'm quite lucky to avoid spam there, or quite skillful. I'm not really sure how I didn't get bumped there. I just saw that sniper drop down now. I didn't see him the first time, definitely. So I'm gonna come up here as engineer, try to expose myself as little as possible. Maybe should have stabbed the pyro there, but I really really wanted the medic because he was the full uber. So already, because a drop at middle like that, especially this late when we already have, is it's, you know, the point was we can get like a minute off the back of that, and then, you know, that wouldn't have happened. So that was my reasoning. I maybe should have stabbed the pyro. Nah, I still stick by my decision, because if I'd stabbed the pyro, I would have just been main spy all the players around me, and it wouldn't really have accomplished much anyway. Like, a pyro standing on their side of the point is not really going to do much. Kitsy's running away here. Decides not to run away anymore. I run away. Q is over this side. Everybody's a bit disconnected at this stage. Not really sure why. Oh yeah, the mini was called out down here actually. And I knew I didn't get him, but I was thinking, I was like, how did I know the mini was there? Because I cheat. Excuse me. So Greg is up here by himself. So at this stage we're kind of a bit disconnected combo wise, but I think we rectify that pretty quickly. Oh, call out Chaco that the spy's on him, but I think it's too late. Yeah, and Cobra comes in and minces him. So gonna come through banana again. This is actually the shortest route where you can't be seen, just straight behind them. That drop down is really really handy for spies. I use it a lot because of it. Unfortunately, back here there's a lot of open areas and stuff. This is a really aggressive decloak. I thought that maybe looked like a backstab, but no, he was turned a bit too much towards me. So, at this point, I think I consider changing loadout, but at the minute, I'm still just trying to stay stock. Especially when I'm trying to learn a map, I often run stock for it because, you know, just vanilla spy. If I'm, you know, then when I'm starting to learn my distances, like if I realize, like, oh, I can't get really behind them without, you know, needing the lat ranger or something, or, you know, different sort of, you know, if pyro and stuff like that. Am I getting kills and then immediately getting killed? Maybe it's time to change to the cloak, the big earner, or even the kunai sometimes. So here, really, really aggressive decloak. Don't know how it works. Paying something the heavy new, too late. The heavy must have heard me, I think. But yeah, sometimes, I mean, if you're in that situation, there's only two of them, heavies are big and make lots of noise, go for the super aggressive decloak. Oh, good force by their soldier. Just appeared out of nowhere. So move through here again. This is nice. This map is actually quite full of routes that are like nice for a spy to get behind people. Think about helping Graggy out. Waffle decloak. Woofle. Oh my god. So think about backing out. Actually, no. Yeah. Oh. Cheeky. Go for the health and the ammo. If anybody had seen me get that, I would have been screwed. Okay, so the heavy's over this side. Unfortunately, he turns around and goes back the other way. I'm sort of forced out of the situation because the pyro knows I'm around and he's spy checking. So I move up this way as the sniper. Don't look at anybody. Last thing I want to do. Don't look at the heavy. Get the medic. Lovely juggly. Again, just walk forwards. Don't necessarily look at anybody. Sort of strafe around a bit if you think that you're playing a bit like the sniper. You know, do things the sniper would do. Don't necessarily just run straight at the medic. Wait for the medic to come to you and it'll work a lot of time. But what is that pyro doing? Oh my god. Just almost worked as well. Holy shit. I remember actually the comms at that point. Q was like, oh yeah, the pyro. So I'm going to try and just shoot this medic. Greggy, of course, on point, straight away, just grabs him. Don't know how I got that credit for that kill. But, oh, Chaco headshot him, and then I just poked him with the revolver. If something dies suddenly a lot of the time, it's just Chaco headshot it. Spy knows. I'm not interested in the spy. I'm leaving. Just get around the corner by the time my cloak goes away. Sniper's on roof, nobody's behind. Medic is right here though. Oh, get him. Yes, I thought I fucked that up actually, but yeah, get the medic and now I'm gonna try and focus the sniper because I really want him dead, because he's one of those assassin classes that'll just if I pick their med, he could immediately just retaliate with that, and I don't want that either, because it kind of gives him more call to be aggressive and stuff. Their whole team actually, if their med just goes down, you'll often find that they'll drop onto yours. I think Q actually might be down here anyway, so maybe I was getting that retaliation pick. No, Q's there. Spies down. Did I do a Borneo video? No, I don't think I did. I'm so bad at this now. I don't know why I haven't been doing so many videos lately. I probably should just do more. I really enjoy doing them, and I learn a lot doing them. I always play better after I do them. But I need to do them. So this weekend, also we've been scrimming a lot at weekends, whereas we used to scrim like maybe Thursday nights, and it gave me a lot more time to get a video up before the game, you know, and give me more of an incentive to do. But now we're often doing like Saturday, Sunday, and then a scrim right before the game, and it means I have less time to actually get these uploaded. Because, especially because my internet now at the minute takes me like, I mean, God knows when you'll see this video. It's, what day is it today? Wednesday. If you see this video Thursday, well done my internet. Okay, they've snoobered, which is the new word for Uber. I'm really trying to get the gun here because it's gonna make the big difference at the end. No point, just doesn't go anywhere. So, is that 2-2? I think it might be. I can hold tab, but it won't do anything. I can hold it anyway. It's a fun key, you know. You can just press it. We're all here to the right. Same old, same old. Calling out spam. Oh, scouts are immediately aggressive, but luckily Graggy shuts them down. Now we're taking through banana here. 65 HP, bit not to the nicest, but I know that there's a health pack really close here, so unfortunately the soldier's taking it. So do I go for the aggressive decloak? I don't think so. No, pyro's too aggressively, he's checking like way too much, you kind of know. So NG goes that way. I think I do change to NG. Pyro knows, second too slow there. But yeah, that was basically, I saw the NG run around, I knew he was going to go back for medal, I'd have a couple of seconds, they knew he had just gone backwards, it was a good disguise I think, but Pyro was just on the lookout, so missed out on that opportunity. Oh yeah, we lost our soldier actually, so Wolf jumped in here, and then Cobra came back, so we suddenly had 9 players again. Scouts on me. I think I'm going to lose this one. Yeah, don't even know why I engage in it. Probably, well, you see, when you're that close to a scout, it's very, very easy for them to keep an eye on you. Hit 20,000 kills in a scatter gun, actually. Yeah, he's a good scout. So, does Q get out of here? Oh, there's Cobra. Don't know what that sniper was thinking. Suddenly a soldier. Okay, so. Jump through here. Shoot at the guys. A heavy demo takes a lot, call that out, because a lot of the time your team, if you, so Tizzy could have done like, you know, 100 damage to that demo, but he might necessarily know how much health he had in the first place. So here I'm gonna shoot the the gun, because the heavy really at that range with the, is that the Tomislav he's using? Even with the Tomislav, you can't do a whole pile of damage to me from that range. And also heavies have short-term memory loss, so I'm just going to turn around and come straight back once he's forgotten about me. And gotta move out here. Oh, gun went down, I think. Yeah, heavy's pretty low, call that out. Yanni's gonna go in and finish that off, I think, or at least try. Oh my gosh, this, ooh, who's coursing? There's an NG, I think. So now they've conched. This makes it really, really hard for me if they conch, because players are going to move very inconsistently in terms of speed. My frame rate's going to drop to 11, and Scott's going to get me again. But yeah, always be careful when you're going into a conched team, because when you're strafing up kind of behind them, you'll a lot of the time their speed can just change at willy nilly depending on how close they are to their soldier. So whereas you think you can predict their movement, suddenly they're, you know, 10 feet away, or 10 meters as we say in Europe, because feet and meters are exactly the same, if anybody's wondering. If they tell you they're not, they're lying, they don't understand the metric system. Heavy's really low, get the assist there, because assists are where it counts. Watch Cobra die fabulously in front of me, take a big old crossbow from the random number generator there. I don't really understand how the damage works on the crossbow. Sometimes I have just no idea. Shoot somebody with it, it might heal them completely, or it might kill somebody, or do no damage at all. I have really no idea. Look at all the hiding down there. Oh my god, that was so funny. The SWAG goes down pretty easily to Code. It's like Code is one of those players you never really hear much from, but he's always quite good for the support. Like, he's always kind of behind. He's not really too aggressive of an engineer, but he's always there to, you know, whereas a push to where they go behind us should go a lot worse. It usually doesn't, because he's there. Ah, yeah, the medal there. I actually take the medal because, unfortunately I get bumped. I get shot here by the heavy. He wasn't even meaning to hit me. He just kind of got the thing. Oh, of course, it's the heavy. Oh, there's their dead medic, actually. The Boosty Boys. Your mom rushes in and says, "What's that noise?" So Spies Banana, call him out. Try and shoot the heavy to death using bullets. Unfortunately, heavies are resistant to bullets. He's using the regular minigun actually, which does, you can't really do a whole lot to me from there. So, I mean, 25 damage. And again, gonna come up here. Spam over from the right side. Okay, so at this stage, like, with that many players around, maybe I should have changed. Maybe I should have tried to go behind. I probably could have gotten behind quite easily, going through drop down and then rotating around. Latranger, this point, probably would have been the better option, because the spam I'm doing with the gun is working out a little bit, but not amazingly. You know, it's helping, but. So I'm getting kills with it now that I talk about it, or I'm getting fucking damage and bullying people away, but. Not exactly the most intimidating class. Shit, I didn't think we'd lose that, but that's 3-2. So that's the video. Hope you enjoyed it. I think the bumpiness was probably not as bad as I'm making it out. I just like everything to look good. Gonna do some Vanguard videos, some Badwater videos. I don't know if it's Badwater or Badwater Pro. I like Badwater Pro a good bit more, because Third Point on old Badwater used to have all sorts of trouble with just the distances you had to travel and the availability you had with all the different cloaks. You were basically tied to using the Latranger at that point, or the Ambassador trying to snipe the NG. Very different now. Hopefully we're playing Badwater Pro. I'll have to check, and I will let you know this weekend when I upload my next video. Okay, bye guys.